Good morning and welcome to this service of worship. I'm Paige McRight, interim pastor here at Oakland Presbyterian Church, and we are so glad that you're joining us for worship this morning. As we prepare for the beginning of fall, and it seems like summer just got here, as we prepare for the beginning of the fall season with school starting tomorrow, there are some important occasions coming up that I want to call to your attention. Children's choir here begins in an online program. The details of that are in the August newsletter from the church, and we hope that families will take advantage of that opportunity for children to learn music and prepare to share their gifts in worship leadership with an online, on-screen song to aid our worship from time to time. Also, the children's band program is starting online. Amy Duncan would love to know if there are children you know who want to be a part of band this fall, and you can be in touch with her at her email address. If you need help with either of those registrations, Stacy in the church office will be glad to hear from you. The other thing is the Presbyterian Women's Bible Study will begin here at the church in September. This coming Saturday, the Presbytery hosts an overview of this year's Bible study. There was an announcement of that in this week's bulletin, and if you look up the email that was delivered to you on Friday, you'll find a link to register for that study this coming Saturday. That concludes the morning announcements. Thank you.
A feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Worthy is Christ the Lamb who was slain, whose blood set us free to be people of God. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Call ourselves to worship by reading responsively verses from Psalm 16. Protect me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
I say to you, the Lord, you are my Lord. I have no good apart from you.
The Lord is my chosen portion, my cup. You hold my lot.
The boundary lines have fallen for me in pleasant places. I have a goodly heritage.
Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. Let us worship God. Our hymn is, If Thou But Trust in God to Guide Thee.
Trust in God to guide thee with hope and heart through all thy ways. God will give strength whatever betide thee to bear thee through the the rock that not can move. Only be still and wait God's leisure in cheerful hope with heart content to take whatever thy keeper's pleasure and all discerning love hath sent. No doubt what inmost wants are clear to one who holds us always dear. Sing, pray, and swerve not from God's ways, but to thine own heart heavenly. Trust the rich promises of praise, so shall they be fulfilled in thee. God never yet forsook at need, for so secured by trust.
Scripture tells us that if we say we are without sin, we are strangers to the truth, and there is no help in us. But if we make bold to confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, stands ever ready to hear and to forgive. In that assurance, let's confess this morning using the prayer of confession that you'll see in your bulletin or on the screen. Lord of all time and space, always the same, full of love and power, coming to your children to give them strength and to challenge them to service. Forgive us for using time selfishly for our own ends, for wasting time and for wishing it away. Teach us that you are Lord of all our moments, that every minute of the day or night we can say, now is God's time. Now God is with us. Amen. Friends, hear the good news. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Thanks be to God. Let us share the peace of Christ with each other using hand signals. Peace be with you. Amen.
Rejoice and be glad. Blessed are you. Holy are you.
Good morning. At this time, I'd like to invite the children and the children at heart come a little bit closer to the screen for our children's sermon. Well, friends, tomorrow is the start of a new school year for most of us. The beginning of this school year is so very different than ever before. Some of you are starting in person tomorrow. Some of you are starting with virtual school, some are starting homeschool, some are continuing with homeschool. We all have questions, some stress, frustrations, and a little bit of fear as we enter this new school year. Usually, the Sunday before school starts, I like to do a blessing of the backpacks. But in this season of change, we can't gather in person, and our school year this year is more than backpacks and crayons and markers. It's also laptops and computers and whatnot. But I think this year, students, teachers, parents, and administrators need our prayers and blessings more than ever this year. So friends, this year, as we enter this new school year, I want to encourage you to be a light. Matthew 5, verse 14 says, "You are the light of the world." And then in verse 16, Matthew says, "Let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." So I encourage you to go into the world, your schools, whether it's online, at home, or in person, and be Christ's light. Don't let your light go out in this season of change. I want you to be a light of love for all. Encourage friends who might be scared. Make new friends with someone who might be new to this area and starting out with virtual school. Make at least one person smile every day just by you being you. Be the light of patience when days are long, when technology does not work, when new ways of learning, new ways of doing things are hard. Be thankful for the light of others, teachers, parents, and administrators who work hard every day to create fun, engaging, and challenging ways to lead us in learning this year. Be the light of joy for a new school year, new friends, and new ways of learning. Remember, friends, you are the light of the world. This year may be tough and challenging, but I hope you will go into the world and shine bright with kindness, patience, energy, and love. And above all, remember, God is with us before, during, and after this school year. Will you join me in an echo prayer? Let us pray. Dear God, at the start of this school year, we are beginning something new. New things can be exciting.
New things can be exciting.
New things can be scary.
New things can be scary.
New things can be wonderful.
New things can be wonderful.
New things can be confusing.
New things can be confusing.
God, you are always with us.
God, you are always with us.
You are with us when things are exciting.
You are with us when things are exciting.
Or scary.
Or scary.
Or wonderful.
Or wonderful.
Or confusing. You are with us every day, and all the time. God, please help us to feel your presence on the first day of school and every day. Amen.
As we prepare for the reading of Scripture, let's lift our hearts in prayer together. God, we pray that the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts will be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen.
Our scripture reading today is from Psalm 42, verses 1 through 6a. As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me continually, "Where is your God?" These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I went with the throng and led them in procession to the house of God, with glad shouts and songs of thanksgiving, a multitude keeping festival. Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Lee. The Psalms are the songbook of the Bible, and the book is full of all different kinds of psalms. They're psalms of praise and rejoicing. They're psalms of lament. They're psalms of quiet content. They're psalms of ascent, those psalms that the ancient Israelites sang as they climbed the mountain toward the temple in Jerusalem. And there are psalms that Old Testament scholar Walter Brueggemann has referred to as psalms of disorientation and reorientation. Psalms 42 and 43 together are one of those psalms of disorientation and reorientation. Lee read to us the first six verses, the first stanza, and the first repetition of the refrain of that psalm. There are two more stanzas, and the refrain is repeated twice more. And I hope after worship today, you'll turn in the book of Psalms to 42 and 43 and read the rest of them. In these psalms, the psalmist cannot make pilgrimage to the temple in Jerusalem. We don't really know why. My study Bible says that it's because he has a deep wound. Other commentaries say it's because this psalm was written in exile by an Israelite cut off from the land, cut off from the temple, because he was in a foreign land. We don't know. What we do know is in verse 10, which comes after our reading for this morning, the psalmist says that the taunts of the people are like a deadly wound in his body. And all of us know that cruel, hateful words spoken in rage do feel like a knife in the gut. The psalmist is disoriented. Things are not like he remembers. Things are not like they ought to be in his world. He cannot go to the temple. He cannot lead the people in procession up the Temple Mount. Yet, even as he remembers things the way they used to be, he experiences reorientation. Remembering God's faithfulness, which he celebrated with others in the past, he finds hope for a future in which he shall again praise God in the company of those who worship and who rely on God's faithfulness for their own lives and for the life of the world. Somehow this psalm seems to me to be especially helpful for us today. We come to the Lord's table separated. We are not able to all physically gather here to be present at the table as we celebrate the Lord's Supper. In his frustration with those who mocked him, in his pain at being separated from fellow worshipers, the psalmist relied on his memory of the past. Memory is a precious thing. It's both a tool for learning, as some of us will discover tomorrow when we go back to school and realize the things that we have forgotten over the course of the summer and need to learn again. It happens every year to all of us, I promise. Memory is also a resource for remembering God's faithfulness to us, a source of hope for the future. It has been said that those who forget the past are doomed to repeat it. I'm not sure about us, but I know this. Those who forget the past are cut off from the wisdom it can provide as we reflect both on those good and courageous decisions that were made in the past and those mistakes that were made, both of which, to a large extent, shape our lives today. Worse even, those who forget or ignore the history of God's faithfulness recorded in Scripture are cut off from understanding the source of life itself. Remembering his past with God, the psalmist finds hope for the present and the future. As we gather at the table at a distance this morning, I invite you to remember times when you have gathered in the sanctuary to celebrate the Lord's Supper. It may be times that you remember Bob standing at the table, praying the great prayer of thanksgiving, breaking the bread and offering the cup. It may be a first communion, your own or one of someone you love. It may be a special service in a different sanctuary or on a retreat. This morning, I remember times when, with an elder from a congregation where I worshiped or served, I took communion elements that had been blessed at the table on Sunday afternoon to members who were in hospital or were in care facilities. And in those small, intimate gatherings with the resident, perhaps a family member, perhaps a small group of residents, the elder and I shared and extended the fellowship of the table. It's a wonderful reminder to me that the love and the sustaining presence of God goes far beyond the sanctuary doors and includes all of us, whether we are gathered or separated. As you come to the table today, I hope that you will bring your memories and share this sustaining feast, looking beyond that which separates us now to the time when this congregation will be again gathered. Look to the future God has in store for you. Hope in God, for we shall again praise him together, and today we celebrate his love for us, gathered at this extended table. Thanks be to God. Amen. Our hymn is "Draw Us in the Spirit's Tether."
Spirit's tether, for when humbly in your name, two or three are matched together, you are in the midst of them. Alleluia. And with thanks.
God the Father, break the bread and bless the cup. Alleluia, alleluia. So now bind our friendship up. All our meals and all our living make a sacrament for you, that by caring, helping, giving, we may be disciples too. Alleluia, alleluia. We will serve with faith anew.
Let us affirm our faith as we say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us
Please pray with me. God of grace and glory, we praise you for this beautiful world in which you call us to live, for the fellowship of faith which sustains our life and draws us close to you and to others in this faith family. Thank you especially for Christ our Savior, whose love makes it possible for us to share love with those whom we meet, friends and also strangers among us. We pray today for friends and family in this congregation, for the Wades as they prepare to move, and for Gloria Lennox as she prepares to move to Charlotte to be close to family. We pray for Clarence Hurt and for Shirley Wakefield in hospital, your healing mercy, that they may be strengthened to enjoy the life that you offer. We pray for those who are facing surgery this week and for all who are anxious about finances, about health. We pray for those mourning loss and for those remembering loved ones from whom they are separated by death until we are reunited at the throne of grace. We give you thanks especially for Donald McCorkadale's love of his wife, Susan, celebrated in the beautiful flowers that grace our sanctuary this morning. We pray for those returning to school or going to school for the first time, for teachers and students alike, that in this new way of being school for many, you will guide and direct, calm, so that learning can happen and joy can be found in a new way of learning. We pray for leaders of states and nations coping unexpectedly with this virus and coping with all of the stresses that leadership brings. Grant to them, whether they know you or know you not, wisdom to know that leadership is a trust for the benefit of the governed, and guide them in their way. Hasten the day, we pray, promised in the prophets, when people will beat swords into plowshares and spears into pruning hooks, and no one will study war or conflict anymore. All this we pray in the name of the Prince of Peace, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. As we continue our worship, I invite you to bring your gifts, your tithes and offerings. And if you came to this service unprepared for the celebration of the Lord's Supper, this would be a great time to find a little bread and something to drink so that you are prepared when we come to the table. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, a kiss our hands have brought, and bless the work our hearts have planned. Us is the faith, the will, the thought. The rest, O God, is in
Gracious God, we dedicate our gifts to your service, asking that you will bless and use them to further your purpose in the world around us, through Christ our Lord. Amen. This is the glorious feast of the people from God. Scripture tells us that people will come from east and west and north and south to sit at table in the kingdom. This table does not belong just to this congregation. It is the Lord's table, and all who put their trust in him are invited and encouraged to take part in the feast he offers us. Let us pray together the great prayer of thanksgiving. You will begin with me responsively, if you will, and we will together conclude the prayer with the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise to you, O God, for you are holy. And blessed is Jesus Christ, your word made flesh. Christ is the word that brought order to chaos, bringing all things into being, breathing spirit into dust. Christ is the light that overcame the darkness, shining from the dawn of creation to the daybreak of your eternal realm. Christ is the water that quenches our thirst, flowing from the hearts of believers and springing up into eternal life. Christ is the bread that rises from the earth, feeding the poor and hungry, giving us wisdom and strength for each day. Christ is the vine that connects all creation, binding us together in the unity of the Spirit, causing us to bear fruit for the world. Christ is the life that death could not destroy, who gave his life in love for the world, who lives and reigns forever. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these your gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and blood of Christ. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ and one with all who share this meal, united in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be Christ's body for the world. Keep us faithful until the time when they will not hurt or destroy on all your holy mountain, when the earth will be full of your glory as the waters cover the sea. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. As Christ our Savior taught us, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Scripture tells us on the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, as has been done in his name, he broke it and gave it to his friends. And then he took the cup after supper and said, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for many for the forgiveness of sin. All of you drink of it. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. Give you thanks, eternal God, that you have fed us at the table in this sacrament. And we pray that you will fill us with a vision of your new creation where all may have life abundantly, and help us see how we can be instruments of your grace to help bring that new creation into fullness through Jesus Christ, the bread of life. Amen. Our hymn is My Hope is Built on Nothing Less.
My hope is built on nothing less. than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness veils his lovely face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. His oath, his covenant, his blood support me in the overwhelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When he shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then in him be found. Trust in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all of the ground is sinking sand. The ground is sinking sand.
And now go out into the world in peace. Hold fast to that which is good. Have courage. Render no one evil for evil. Support the weak. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Help those who are in need. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And may the one who creates us go with us and before us. The one who saves us lead us into everlasting life. The one who gives us wisdom guide us in the way of peace. Amen.
May be